basically VLSI is very large scale integrated circuit, which means that in a small circuit we have many components integrated in. Before this, whatever CPUs, memories we had, they were all separate. Like we have our desktops, right? They have CPU separately, and in that we had our memories. But with VLSI, the case is that all these things are integrated into one circuit, which can be as small as 3 nanometers. So this started in the 1970s, and one most common example of VLSI circuit we can say is a microcontroller. So what are the applications? We have a mobile phone now. We all use it to talk to other people. We call them in messages. Apart from that, nowadays we can also use mobile phones to edit a Word document. We can even export into a PDF and all such things. This is one of the main applications of VLSI. And how it is useful is that it is very reliable. And we can also, the operating speed of our mobile phones is very high, and we can even do multiple tasks at once on a mobile phone. All this is because of the VLSI. And also, as I have already told before, the size can be as small as 3 nanometers. The 3 nanometer size is the distance, is the gate length. That will be discussed in depth later. So now we will see the VLSI design flow. It starts with the system specification. So what is system specification? When a vendor comes to the company, that they want a particular chip, so they specify what are the specification they need in that chip. Then we have the architectural specification. So in the system specification, we are provided with the size of the chip, the area of the chip which we want the company to design. Next is the architectural specification. We decide what kind of architecture, for example RISC or CISC. Then apart from that, we also see what kind of pipeline and how many pipelines we would want the chip to have. After that, we have the behavioral specification. So in this behavioral specification, you can also call it as functional specification. Here what we have is that all the components which we are going to embed in the chip are in the form of a black box. So here black box means that we know the inputs and outputs, but we don't know what is the internal circuitry of any module present in the chip, and we also know the interconnections between them. So here in behavioral specification, since we know only the inputs and outputs, we will write a code. For example, we will use hardware description language, which nowadays the most commonly used is Verilog, to describe the module. For example, if we have an anvil, so Verilog is written like this. For an anvil, if the inputs are A, B and the output is C, we will write like, name it a module, we will name the module as an, then we will write the inputs and outputs. After this, we will specify what are the inputs, what are the outputs. Then we will also specify what is the output. Now, we will specify how these will work. So, we will write C will be equal to, and so we will take another wire. So, we will write X is equal to and C equal. This is how a Verilog would be written for each module, and also the behavioral specification we can see how they are connected. So Multiplex. For example, if you want to use a 4:1 multiplex, that all So in floor plan, what happens is that we have the chip. It has a particular core area and die area within which all the modules have to be embedded. Here, as I have already told, when we have two or three modules of the same hierarchy, we make sure that they are together at the same in the same area so that communication between them will be easy. Here also in the floor plan, there are options of inserting other cells like level shifters. So basically, level shifter, what it does is that, for example, if we have two power domains, your power domain means that some components work at a particular power and other components work at another power. So when we have to transfer a signal from one power domain to the other power domain, at that point, level shifters are used. So in the floor plan stage, we, apart from inserting whatever components we are needed, we also insert other cells. After the floor plan, we have the power plans. So power plans say basically here is that we will provide VDD, that is power and ground rails in this power plan step. So basically for this we use the higher metal layers because they have less resistance and power carries a lot of current. So here basically in the power plan, the VDD and VSS are mostly given to the form of a mesh. Next, after this we have the placements. In the floor plan, we have already placed whatever components we need. Here in the placement step, we will place whatever standard cells are there in our design. For example, the case like AND, OR and NOT, these are all called standard cells. And in this step, we will place all of them and also make sure that there is some space for routing of the wires for connection between the components. So now after this, we will see CPS step. CPS is basically clock tree synthesis, which means that in this step we will make sure that the clock from the clock pin we will be able to take it to all the other components. After this we have routing, which is basically the connection between all other